Hi, everyone.
This is Mike Arnaldo from New Math Coffee here with Leaderboard. I'm here to reveal and talk about the coffee that we submitted for the lineup in season 6. So the coffee is Argopuro Natural Hydro Honey. It's from this village called Tlogosari at the foot of Mount Argopuro in East Java, Indonesia. The processing method is natural hydro honey, and so that's the first thing that caught my eye when I read about the coffee. That's a processing that I've never heard of before, and this is my first time trying it, you know, roasting it and brewing it myself. So it's a three-step process. The first step is the cherries are picked, sorted, and sun-dried on raised beds, just like a natural processed coffee would be. And then the second step is where it gets interesting, is the cherries are rehydrated before finally being depulp, and then the seeds with the mucilage are sun-dried again on raised beds, and that's the third step. That's where the honey process comes in. The cultivars are Lini S795 and Kartika. For those of you who drink Indonesian coffee often, you might have come across S795 often. It is a widely planted cultivar in Indonesia, and both its origin country, India. It's disease resistant, especially to leaf rusts, and very easy to grow. So that's why you'll see S795 spread throughout different Indonesian coffee origins. As for Kartika, the second cultivar, so Kartika is a Sanskrit word. It means star or goddess, and it's actually a common first name you'll find in Java. But of course, we Indonesians, we love abbreviations. So Kartika actually also stands for Kopi Arabica Tipe Katai. So Katuai, Katai is Katuai, and so Kartika is a local expression of the Katuai cultivar. It's not super widely grown because it's not as disease resistant, and it's actually really susceptible to a lot of diseases, including nematodes and leaf rust. But it does grow well, according to some farmers, in central Java, especially area called Wonosobo. And so it makes sense. Wonosobo is the neighboring region to East Java, where this lot comes from. So it makes sense to see this cultivar being included in the farms there. So as far as identifying the coffee, I wouldn't know how to identify a natural hydro honey because I'm not familiar with that processing at all. But I would say, you know, if you look at the beans closely, to me, it tells me that it looks like a honey process to me, because it has a mix of beans without the silver skins and beans with the silver skins. So, usually when I see that, and that stands in contrast to something like a washed coffee from Ethiopia, where the silver skins are really prominent, versus the honey process stands in contrast to natural coffees as well, where sometimes you won't see silver skins at all on the roasted coffee. So yeah, I would see this beans, and I would call it honey process. And the sensory flavor profile to me actually indicates honey process more than anything else. So you get a good amount of berry notes, some winey notes as well, like some sweet vermouth. But there's a balance, especially I think when I start roasting the coffee fresh, it would be on a nutty note. And then once you roast the beans, I get more of a bright lemon and pineapple notes sometimes, depending on how you would brew it. I think if I get a berry forward coffee, but it's not, you know, the intensity is not 11 and it's just like good, or 8 or 9 out of 10, and then somewhere on a balanced note, I would think of that as I would identify that as a honey processed coffee. And I wouldn't say this is a good archetype of S795 and Kartika. I can't answer that, because as much as I've tasted many Indonesian coffees, I haven't tasted enough of S795 or Kartika on their own to be able to identify those cultivars. My palate is not trained enough for that. But at the same time, you know, this coffee shows really meticulous and clean processing, and that's thanks to the farmer, Mr. Muhlisin, but also with, in cooperation with the exporting company, Belift Green Beans, and thanks to Belift that I was able to source this coffee through sustainable harvests in Portland, Oregon, and I'm very happy to have done so, and I'm very happy to see the work that's being done in East Java. As I've said, it's a region I like to see more of in the US. So I don't have any specific tips for brewing. Maybe it touches on the way I like to roast. I roast fairly light, but I want to make sure that the coffee is soluble, so it makes the coffee forgiving and suitable for several brewing methods. If I'm at home, I would just, you know, doing a pour over, I would do a 1-16 ratio, medium coarse grind, and yeah, 205 on water temperature. So far, that's what I've been doing for brewing this coffee, and I've tried this also in espresso. Yeah, so that's it. That's my presentation. Thanks for listening, and thanks for playing. Enjoy.